Dear friends, dear colleagues, nice to see you all here at Volksbühne. First of all, I want to thank Yannis and his fellows for organizing this, I think, very important event today. And I hope, and I think we hope, it will be the start point of a real important and a real strong movement for more democracy in Europe. So, today I'm speaking to you as one of the initiators of a call, Founding Europe Anew, that was initiated in 2012, and it was supported from many unionists, from academics and intellectuals. This call is a bleeding for a radical path change in the European integration process. It asks for an end of austerity and neoliberalism, and for a new policy of solidarity and democracy. Let me shortly quote. It says, Europe needs a democracy offensive. The EU will have no positive future as a detached elite project. Europe's population must be involved concerning core questions. We plead for a Europe social movement of citizens which embarks on a radical change of path and acts against the current disastrous crisis policy in Europe. I think, dear friends, dear comrades, I think these words put out what has to be said and, more important, what has to be done, and let's do that together. So, after that, we made another call, a solidarity call for the new government in Greece. It was said, Greece after the election, not a threat, but an opportunity for Europe. And this was also signed and supported by all German trade union leaders. So, friends and colleagues, why do I mention this? I think it's obviously that there are many commonalities between our activities and the manifesto of Diem we are discussing today and in the next days, the next weeks, the next month. And I think both share a common idea, maybe a common dream. It is more democracy is what Europe needs most. But this idea, this dream is not enough. Let me make one point. We have to start a debate amongst ourselves what our idea of democracy should be, as I think we need a widespread plan of democratization. The EU currently doesn't only suffer from a lack of legitimation and from fiscal policy. It also threatened by a brutal social division that is destroying social cohesion and solidarity within and between member states. Increasing poverty, rising unemployment, especially of young people, and a huge inequality are scandals we cannot put up with. That's true. But the point is, if we fail in fighting these scandals, our vision of political democracy will stay a castle in the air. And because of that, we have to put a democracy plan that goes beyond political institutions. We have to find European capitalism as both as a political and as an economic power. And for that, let me be clear, it's about political, but it's also about social, and it's also about economic democracy. It's about democracy against the power of the financial markets. It's about democracy to weaken the neoliberal elite in the political and in the economic sphere. We have to consider that, otherwise we will not be successful. We have to fight the current capitalism as it is, as a political and as an economic power, and I think we should do this also together. And friends, colleagues, comrades, I cannot speak as a German trade unionist without mentioning one point. I think it's obviously that the left and also the unions in Germany have a particular responsibility for a better union, for a better Europe. Germany is a hegemon in Europe, and the German government is a spearhead of austerity. So, we have to have a European struggle, but a domestic too. We have to put our government under pressure, because without a radical change of German policy, there will be no future for a better Europe. And this is our task here in Germany, and this is what we have to do. As a German unionist, I know what I say. It's not that easy to do. We tried it sometimes, and we were not always successful. But I think we need to continue to try it. In my opinion, the thing is that we have to do that together. My comrades, my colleagues, my friends who made this call, this movement that we are supporting up to now, up tomorrow. And in my opinion, we have to do it without any fear. And we have to do it in a long tradition, a tradition for what the union stands, for what the social movement stands, and for what other forces in the world stands. Yes, we are aware of the specific German responsibility to fight for a better Europe. And I'm sure if we fail, this Europe will not come true. But I think we want not to fail, and we will not fail. And because of that, I'm looking forward for a strong movement with a manifesto of Diem, with a strong movement for another, for a better Europe. And now I say, let's stand up and fight for that. Thank you very much.